Hello, everyone. I hope you guys had a wonderful day and are making some really good trades. Now let's dive in into some analysis here for the SPY and the triple Qs. Again, for the SPY, it is definitely looking increasingly rough here. And I've already let my members know that there is tremendous downside risk. And that's why I'm not, you know, looking to really buy the dip at the moment. Although I know that the larger trend is towards the upside, we are currently in a topping phase and looking for this market to finally find a top as we approach, economic Armageddon, I would say. But again, that shit's been going on for quite a while and, you know, the market's been going up. So there's no point in really fighting the tape. But right now, there is cause for concern. I think the Qs are kind of showing that right now. Qs, the tech sector is very weak. That's probably my favorite place to go looking to go look for shorts. And we are currently in some shorts. Most of our shorts are in profit. I probably say out of the five, I think we got five shorts going on right now. I think four out of five are in the money. Correction, three out of five are in the money right now. But again, it's got to be patient with these trades. And again, really like the plays that I'm in right now. And I'm probably going to continue to sit on them until I see a real change in the structure of the market. Now, this dip that we're getting right here could be a buyable dip. You know, we got nice reaction yesterday, nice reaction kind of today. But again, it was met with a lot of selling. And you could take a look at NVIDIA. You know, the NVIDIA sell area was up here. And I told you guys weeks in advance that this was going to be the target most likely. And once we hit it, we went into it, distribution, and then we fell after earnings, right? And now the next buy area for NVIDIA that I see is going to be at $81, right? 81 to 59. And people are like, that's never going to happen. It's not going to happen in your dreams, right? Well, you know, we had a bunch of sell areas here. Buyers down here, buyers here, in your dreams. Well, you know, it's dream come true for me. It's a dream come true for a lot of the members because we continue to reap the rewards of big impulses towards the upside and, you know, nailing shorts and, you know, nailing tops and nailing bottoms. But it doesn't always work, right? That's why I stop out of trades when it doesn't go my way. Like Roku. Roku is arch nemesis of stopping me out and I'm not going to trade this anymore. But although it's respecting the flat nicely now, I guess. But they're not going to look. I'm not going to go back. I'm not going to go back to that one. Let's take a look at Apple, right? This was the sell area for me, the short. And again, I think we're probably in a bigger corrective move here. The way it rallied up quite nicely in the five-wave move. Again, if this is not a... What do I have this label as? One, two, three. No, this would be... Sorry, this is mislabeled. This would be like a larger 1-2. So this would be something like this, a 1-2, right? And if this is a buyable dip, then ultimately Apple is going to have to come down lower, right? And that's why I say the SPY could be on its way down to lower prices, but it might not get there right away. It's going to be very choppy. It's going to be very sloppy. It's going to go up and down, left and right. Now you're getting a red cross on on wave edge, right? So if the Apple continues to bleed lower, then you're going to see Apple and a lot of these mega cap stocks, the stocks that everyone loves, is going to continue to go lower as well into the buy area. And I'm going to be buying the dip once it gets down to these levels. And I wasn't buying the dip here, probably because it was like market crash concerns, but clearly looks like this was the dip buy, and whoever was brave enough to do this, then congrats. You know, you would have gotten an amazing opportunity here, and it would have ended very nicely for you, right? And I told you guys this was probably a flat 1-2-3, and now it's finished, and we got rejected from this area. The next target is down here, Google. Let's take a look at Google. So Google's very similar situation, a three-wave move up, a little bit uglier though, and it looks like it ended. And as it continues to capitulate, now if we break this pivot, we're most likely headed down to 130. So 130 is the target area for Google, and I would actually like to buy the dip on Google as well. But again, I will wait. I will be patient. And these targets may seem out of reach right now, but they may not be out of reach later on. And we'll take a look at some key factors here. So the USD JPY, the pair, is obviously putting a lot of pressure on the markets to go lower. Unless it can be saved here and it continues to rally up, then hey, like shit, like this is gonna be, this is a dip buy and it's gonna continue to go up. But we'll see. Like if this X wave is not in here, then it's gonna it needs to extend higher, right? But right now, as far as I see a flat that could have played out here, and which is technically still holding, although I don't like the structure at all, right? This looks like it could be another WXY, like another another correction within the correction. But if it wants to extend, it needs to do it now, right? It needs to do it now. And let me see what the target would be for this here. Because we went a little bit lower. I mean, you could make the case that this is an ABC, but for now, if you're going to continue to rally up, the target could be a little bit lower down to here. So that's where I'll be looking for probably a short, but for now, let's leave, you know, everything as is. Excuse me. And we'll go from there. Okay, so that's what I got for you guys right now. In terms of this, but if you break down lower and you take out this pivot, then you all bets are off, and this market's probably gonna go down much more, and it's gonna be unfortunate. But that's what it is. All right, let's talk about the yields. So I talked about the yields with my members here, but I'll cover it very thoroughly tonight with you guys. So US, it's right here. Let me just pull it up. So the 20-year yield looks like it's about to get a big capitulation move, like we just got up here at 4.58%. We got this red diamond before and it had a big move down, right? And looks like we're gonna get the same thing now. Doesn't always occur, right? Especially if you got green money flow, you're in an uptrend in yields, then these signals don't really mean much. But it's when you're in downtrends, you're in a downtrend and you get these signals, then you got to pay attention, because this could mean that, hey guys, like yields are about to get a big capitulation move. Maybe this is going to be supported by very weak US economic data, and you know, you better batten down the hatches and be careful, right? Be careful, don't long too many things, right? And because if this is the case, then people are going to pile into bonds and get out of equities. This is a risk-off signal. And we've been tracking TLT for a very long time. And it looks like we're finally getting a nice impulse out now. So wave three here popping off. Let's get on some smaller time frames. So there you go. Wave three impulse. Boom. Taking out this high. Not yet. So if we can take out this high, that'd be great. But if it doesn't want to, that's okay. You know, you could make the case I got too many counts here. You can make the case that this is just pulling back, and then this is another fifth wave, and then we're gonna extend this third wave here, and then so on and so forth. But again, just know that the trend is towards the upside in bonds. That's just my opinion, and I mean that's been the kind of the case too. I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, it passed. Okay. All right. Talk about the... it's still there. Talk about the DXY. Looks like it finished wave four today. We should be headed down in its final fifth wave here. And if this is the case, then, you know, the buy area is all the way down here at $98. Oil, again, breaking down, guys. But it should be finishing up some moves here. So let's see. You could probably... capitulated for, and you're kind of sort of like in this fifth wave. So this could have ended today, and tomorrow you're going to get a rally back up in oil. But again, this should be short-lived, and you should get another leg down later on in the fifth wave to finish up the larger third wave. And I mean, I don't think the bottom is in for oil, but we'll see, because it's hitting some pivots and people are getting really bullish again. But you never know. You never know with energy. AI. So the semis are strong. There's nothing wrong. The semis are definitely not strong right now, and they're continuing to go lower. Let me see. Sorry, someone's texting me. We should be going down lower. Big move down here. You should see some follow through. I'm not worried at all. Like, I'm gonna hold my short position on the semis, and I'm gonna just like wait for this to play out. I'm in no rush at all. All right. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of basically it, guys. I don't really have much to update. Like, the market's very choppy. We are either going to make a big move down or a big move up, but I'm betting that it's probably going to be towards the downside. And I mean, the cards are kind of in our favor right now, but you never know. This could double correct, right? This could, like, the correction may not be over, and you're going to do something like this, which means you're going to extend even higher. People are going to get even more bullish before you sucker in more people, and then you'll rip it down later again. But I think you should get this out of the way first before we begin a move higher again and then correcting down even lower. But we'll see what the market has in store for us. So if you guys want to see my trades, you can sign up with the link in the description. Have a good day. Peace.